everybody watching out, we're glad you are joining us. This is the first time we've done something like this, and we're excited to be able to just come together, just here in my living room here in Bailey, North Carolina. We are very excited to be able to just sing these songs and worship with you. We do miss you a lot. It feels like it's been over a month or so, and it's only been a couple weeks, but we do miss being with you in person. So this is different, but this is a new normal for a little bit. And so I have a little bit of scripture I want to read before we get started. And this is from Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, a very popular verse. It says, "Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all He has done. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything that we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus." And as I was reading this verse, the part that stuck out to me is, it says, tell God what you need and thank Him for all He's done. Then you will experience God's peace. And so, these are trying times, these are uncertain times, and it's really easy to get worried, to experience all this anxiety, but me and my coworkers the other day were talking about this, and the one thing that we continue to do through all this is to thank God. Thank God for all He's done. Thank God for what He's doing, what He's going to do, and the ways that He's going to work through this situation, because we do know that He works all things out for our good and for His glory, and we can't wait to see how He will be glorified through all this. And so I got Brandon with me, and so we're just going to sing some songs together. Feel free to join in. These are songs that we've sang at church in our time of worship together. So before we do that, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Wherever you are, bow your heads and let's pray together. Father, we thank you. God, we thank you for your presence among us, Lord. Although we are not gathered here, we know that you are with us. You're with us individually, God. You're with us in the good times and in the bad. And God, we thank you for technology, God, that we can still do this, that we can still meet virtually, online, and we can still connect to one another, that we're never distant from one another. And God, we thank you for the community that we have in Nashville United Methodist Church and in the town of Nashville and Rocky Mountain, the ways that you continue to bring us together, even when the world and when the enemy tries to divide us, God. We still unite under the banner of Jesus Christ. And we just pray for healing over the sick ones now. We pray for protection over those who may be at risk, Father. But we know that you are above all sickness. You are above all disease. And we believe that, and we declare that tonight as we sing these songs. And above all, we give you thanks for who you are, for all you've done and all that you promised to do. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Alright, so we're going to sing this together.
Let praise be a weapon that conquers all anxiety. Let it rise. Let praise.
stay with us. These things happen.
Yeah, remember what the pastors always say, that the church is not a building. And it really is good to have times like these when we can't get together. It's almost as if God is wanting us to be a little bit more still and find ways to rest. But when we rest, it doesn't mean that we can't worship. We can't join together. I'm really thrilled that we've got this time together.
Yeah. We need to come up with a name for this. If this is something we're going to be doing weekly, drop some in the comments if you have any ideas. Thinking some living room sessions, house sessions, something like that. So I think we're back up and running. We're going to sing this one. No familiar one. We're going to sing Yes, I Will. Here we go.
Treasures of faith are never enough.
praise you. We thank you for every blessing that you have bestowed upon us. Father, we know that today we are surrounded by your Spirit, by your presence. And we are reminded that even though we feel like we're surrounded by fear, anxiety, Lord, that you are in front of us, behind us, beside us, always lifting us up. Father, let our hearts rest in you tonight, Lord. Let us think only of you and focus on this moment alone, this one moment, Lord, where we can be at peace, at rest, knowing that you are still a sovereign God, a living God that is still active today. Father, remind us of who you say we are, who we are as a church, who we are as a people, who we are as the body of Christ, that we may come together over a digital connection, Lord, and still lift your name up high. We don't have to be in a building, in a room together to praise you, Lord. We don't have to be hand in hand to worship you, because we are all together by your Spirit, Lord. We just ask that you begin healing across our nation. A healing that can't be explained by science, can't be explained in worldly terms, Lord, but it's just a natural, supernatural healing, straight from the Holy Spirit. Father, we ask that you send angels to surround our country. Everyone in every hospital bed, Lord, surrounded by your angels. Let us all know with complete certainty that you are here, because we know you are, Lord. Father, we just ask you to continue to guide us. Guide us through your word, through your signs, your wonders, and your Spirit, Father, that we may continue to be a people rooted in your ministry, your gospel, your name. We ask all these things in the beautiful name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Died and breath has brought me life.
be stopped. God, we thank you for that. We thank you for your presence here in this place, and we pray as we go about our week, Lord, that you will guide us, that you will protect us, that you will just cover us with your love and your grace and your mercy. Let us walk in the light of the gospel, being the church that you call us to be, worshiping you always and fulfilling the identity that you have created us for, to be true worshipers of you in spirit and in truth, and to love as Jesus loves. God, we love you and we thank you, for it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for joining us. We hope to see you next week, and ultimately we hope to see you again soon, that all this will pass. But until then, we love you guys. We thank you for joining us, and have a great week. All right.